Hey guys, I just want to make a really quick little card. I'm hoping it'll be quick. We'll see. This is the new Cakewalk background stamp, and I'm going to try a new technique. I don't know if it's going to work, but we're going to try it. If it doesn't work out perfectly, I think it's still going to be okay. I'm going to make kind of a background using some distress ink. So I'm using Sponge Sugar, Shabby Shutters, and Mustard Seed. I did a preliminary one, and this is what I came up with. I used a different color, of course, but I like it, so we're going to go with that. So I'm just going to put the Sponge Sugar in random places on here, and I'm kind of getting it real good on there. Lots of ink. I like the pink. Okay. I'm going lightest to darkest so I don't really contaminate my pads. Trying to get all the little guys covered. And then last is the shabby. Let me zoom in a little bit. Is the shabby shutter? You can't really see it on there. Sorry, I'll lift it up a little bit. A second. Any spots that I missed? Let's get a little green up there. That's pretty well covered. I still don't think you can see all the ink on there. Oh, there you go. Okay. And then so we're going to use this. This is the same thing, it's just in a different container. I'm not going to soak it. Just a good mist to activate all that ink. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to lay it on here, but I'm going to get another piece of paper so I don't get disgusting. Let's hope I don't smear it. Ready? Not too bad. Not too shabby. I like it. Just do a real quick cleanup of this stamp with a baby wipe. I have to really clean it off later. I'll get with some stamp cleaner and get it. Okay. Get all the glitter off of here. Okay. Not too bad. I like it. Next up, I've got a card base here. This is Stampin' Up's Lucky Limeade paper. I think that's dry. And we're going to just glue this down. I'm just going to use this little this and that from American Crafts in pieces. And this paper is 120 weight. This white paper is the 120 weight cardstock from Gina K Designs. I usually don't use it for stuff like this, but I wanted something that would really hold up to the water. Okay. And I just cut it a little bit smaller than a normal card base. Just to give it a little bit of an outline. Ta-da! Okay. And then, let's see. Next step is I don't know what color this is because I got it in a Stampin' Up like pack of paper, so I don't know what that is. And this is the same Lucky Limeade. And I'm going to use this stamp from Studio Calico and Hero Arts. It's called Hooray! I like it. I'm going to use this little stamper here. Every little thing is going to be alright, and I'm actually going to use both the clouds too. So, lay that down.
Get a stamp block here. I really like these clear blocks from Tim Holtz. Because it's really thin and you can feel what you're really doing. And this is going to go on the green. I'm just going to use some Memento ink. I'm going to put a little bit of black in. Okay. Excuse my head. Okay. I'm going to do my baby wipe away. Okay. And then I'm going to glue this onto, or put this on this pink paper here. I didn't even really measure this. I just kind of eyeballed it to see if it would fit. I was going to cut flag ends. I don't think I'm going to. Yeah, I will. Okay. I'll go for it. So, the easiest way that I found to do this is you literally just cut up into the middle, the very center, however deep you want the V. And it's going to be a little harder because I'm cutting through two papers. And then from the very corner, cut to the center there. And on the other side as well. Yeah, I like the way that looks. Buffing block and buff that. Okay, and same thing on the other side. And you can actually, like, if you really want it to be, like, perfect, you could put this, right here, which is not a bad idea. When you cut this part, just so you know how far to go in. That wasn't perfectly in the center, but that's okay. You can fake it. These scissors are nice and sharp. So we'll cut all the way to that little tiny spot. And if you do get that little tuft there, like I did before, I just take my little buffing block. This is actually a fingernail buffing block, but it's the same thing you would get if you bought one for crafting specially. So there's that. Okay. Next step is I want to make some clouds, and I can't decide if I want tone-on-tone colored clouds or if I want black on color clouds to kind of help tie in that. So we're going to do a little bit of both. Start with the pink. This isn't the exact color pink, but I think it'd be close enough. Cute! Okay. And this one is just a Stampin' Up! Ink. This is this color is Melon Mambo. And then I don't have a Stampin' Up! Color that would match the yellow. So I'm using Memento Dandelion, just this little inker. I don't know, I think I'm going to like the tone on tone, but we'll do black too. That's pretty. And then for the green, I do actually have the Lucky Limeade Stampin' Up! Color. I think I'm gonna stamp that one more time, just because that solid one looks looks a little splotchy. It probably will straighten out as it dries, but just in case. Okay, now I want to do a black on each one. Oh, got it all over my finger. Just pat this a little bit. Cute. I don't know. Excuse me. Oh, the wood grain one didn't come out. About these is I have a punch to get them out, so I don't have to fussy cut them, because that would be a pain. Kind of close on this pink one. I think I have some more of this paper if I mess it up. Cute. Okay. Put this side. All right. So, like I said, I have these Fiskars punches, so I'm going to get to punching. Okay, so I made a couple different things. I'm not completely sure
what I like best.
I think I kind of like the black, but some of them are too harsh. Like I like the green. Oh, that's cute. Okay, might do that. So then like the yellow with the black and green polka dot. And then let's do the pink with the black and yellow. That's cute. Okay. So then let's stick those together. Okay, and then what I think I'm going to do also to tie the black in a little bit more is I'm going to wrap some of this twine right here. So, okay, let's put this up on foam adhesive. And that's going to go right in the middle. Actually, a little high because I'm going to put the string. Let's see. Yeah, we want that to be about there-ish. So I'm going to get, I'll just cut it. I'm just going to cut a little hole. Just big enough for my string to go through. Cute. I'm digging it already. Okay. Trick is you tie a loose, tie a crazy old bow. Then you loosen it up, keeping your fingers on the knot. Get your bow kind of the direction that you want it, and then tighten it up. I don't want the loops quite that big. I always get one loop that's kind of twisted, but meh. I think it's okay. There we go. And then, you know what? I'm going to leave the tails because just in case I want to mess with a little bit more. Okay. Now for my clouds. I think I'm going to do them flat. I might not need all three of them. It's kind of busy. I definitely like the two. Do I like this one better than that one. No, I think I like this one. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put adhesive on the backs of these, just flat adhesive. And then I like this one right here. That's cute. But this one, I kind of want to go underneath. So what I'm going to do is carefully pry up the little, there we go, so I can kind of tuck this guy up under there, just like so, not too far. Yeah. Okay, fix my bow. And then to get my bow to stay still, I think I'm going to actually put a little glue dot underneath it. Probably doesn't really need it, but I don't want it rolling all over the place. So I'm just going to get a little glue dot and just kind of roll it up with my scissors. Put it right underneath there. Perfect. And then one last finishing touch, I'm going to get a black pen and put some stitching lines around the outside. I think I'm just going to use my Memento black pen. That's kind of thick. This ink pen is too thin. I don't have a good black. Ooh, this one's sparkly black. That could be good. We'll go with Memento, I think. I think it'll be okay. Okay. It's my cooler. It's over 90 degrees here today, which is actually cool. Taft in July. Sorry, I don't even know if I'm in camera. I'm just going to do this really quickly. Get a Copic multi-liner pen so I can do this. But this one seems to be working okay. And there you have it. I think it's finished. I'm pretty happy with it. So, thanks for watching.